Psalm 89. I will sing of the Lord's great love forever. With my mouth I'll make your faithfulness known through all generations. I will declare that your love stands firm forever, that you have established your faithfulness in heaven itself. You said, I've made a covenant with my chosen one. I've sworn to David, my servant. I will establish your line forever and make your throne firm through all generations. Once you spoke in a vision to your faithful people, you said, I have bestowed strength on the warrior. I have raised a young man from among the people. I have found David, my servant. With all sacred oil, I have anointed him. My hand will sustain him. Surely my arm will strengthen him. The enemy will not be better of him. The wicked will not oppress him. I will crush his foes before him and strike down on his adversaries. My faithful love will be with him, and through my name his horn will be exiled. I will set his hand over the sea and his right hand over the rivers. He will call out to me, Father, you are my Father, my God, the rock, my Saviour. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
In the sixth month of Elizabeth's pregnancy, God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a town in Galilee, to a virgin pledged to be married to a man named Joseph, a descendant of David. The virgin's name was Mary. The angel went to her and said, Greetings, you who are highly favoured, the Lord is with you. Mary was greatly troubled at his words and wondered what kind of greeting this might be. But the angel said to her, Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favour with God. You will conceive and give birth to a son, and you are to call him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over Jacob's descendants forever. His kingdom will never end.
How will this be? Mary asked the angel, since I am a virgin.
The angel answered, The Holy Spirit will come on you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God. Even Elizabeth, your relative, was going to have a child in her old age, and she who was said to be unable to conceive is in her sixth month. For no word from God will ever fail.
I am the Lord's servant, Mary answered. May your word be fulfilled. Then the angel left her.
Welcome to It Begins in Bethlehem, a nativity rhyme for Christmas time. My name is Kendi, and I'll be leading us through the nativity story today. There will be a lot of opportunities to join in at home, so listen carefully. Our story begins with a woman called Mary. I'll read the verses, but there is a chorus we would like all of you to help us with. Here are the actions that go with the words. Join in if you can from home. God knocks down the proud and lifts up the meek and does mighty things for those who are weak and blesses the ones who service he seeks. So sing out his praise. He's amazing. Let's do it one more time to make sure we've all got it. God knocks down the proud and lifts up the meek and does mighty things for those who are weak and blesses the ones whose service he seeks. So sing out his praise. He's amazing. A woman called Mary was doing her chores. but when an angel arrived, but not through the doors. He simply appeared, and she dropped to the floor. "Hello, Mary," he said. "God is with you."
"God is with me," she wondered. "But what does that mean? What is this all about? Is it some kind of dream?" The angel just smiled. "Don't be scared. Please don't scream. God is happy with you and will bless you."
God knocks down the proud and lifts up the meek and does mighty things for those who are weak and blesses the ones whose service he seeks. So sing out his praise. He's amazing.
"You'll soon have a baby," the angel went on. "A quite special baby called Jesus, God's son, the heir of King David. He'll sit on his throne and his kingdom will last forever."
"But how?" Mary asked. "I don't understand. I'm engaged to be wed, but he's not yet my man." "Trust God," said the angel. "He's got it all planned. His spirit will come upon you."
God knocks down the proud and lifts up the meek and does mighty things for those who are weak and blesses the ones whose service he seeks. So sing out his praise. He's amazing.
"Lord, help us be like Mary, who answered when you asked. Help us learn to give and serve, no matter what the task."
Joseph comes next in our story. He is engaged to Mary, but has just found out that she is having a baby that is not his. There's a chorus for this poem too. And once again, we'd like all you to join in. Here's our actions. Joseph, don't worry. Joseph, don't weep. Lay down your head and go back to sleep. Mary's been faithful. Her love is strong and deep. And her baby is God's own son.
All night Joseph tossed, all night Joseph turned. He just couldn't sleep. He'd only just learned that Mary was pregnant. What's more, she'd confirmed that the baby she bore was not his.
Joseph, don't worry. Joseph, don't weep. Lay down your head and go back to sleep. Mary's been faithful. Her love is strong and deep. And her baby is God's own son.
She told him this tale, an angelic visit, a son to be born by God's Holy Spirit. The more she went on, the less he believed it. He wanted to break their engagement. But as soon as sleep came, that angel appeared. "Don't worry," he said, "there's nothing to fear. I know that you're troubled, so you need to hear that Mary is telling the truth. The baby she bears is God's holy son. Call his name Jesus, for he is the one. God promised to send us to save everyone. Emmanuel, God is with us."
He is the answer to all that the prophet have said. So keep your engagement, be glad, and be wed. And when Joseph woke up, that's just what he did. He took Mary to be his wife.
Joseph, don't worry. Joseph, don't weep. Lay down your head and go back to sleep. Mary's been faithful. Her love is strong and deep. And her baby is God's own son.
Lord, help us to be like Joseph, a man both kind and just. Help us listen when you speak. Teach us how to trust.
Then Mary and Joseph, her husband, went down to be counted by Caesar in Bethlehem town. There were no empty rooms for the couple to stay, so they stopped in a place where the animals lay. And there, in the hay, she gave birth to God's son and cuddled and cradled her small, special one.
It's now it's time for the shepherds and their angel visitors. The chorus goes like this. Sing praise to God and give him glory. Celebrate his wondrous story of love and joy and peace to men. for it begins in Bethlehem. Let's join in together and say that, shall we? Sing praise to God and give him glory. Celebrate his wondrous story of love and joy and peace to men, for it begins in Bethlehem. We'd love you all to join in with these words at home.
Shepherds lying on a hill, the night was silent, all was still. They watched their flock of grazing sheep and tried hard to not fall asleep. But when a bright white angel came to light the night, a fiery flame, the shepherds trembled where they lay. The angel said, "Do not be afraid."
Sing praise to God and give him glory. Celebrate his wondrous story of love and joy and peace to men, for it begins in Bethlehem.
The news is good, the news I bring. Good news to make you leap and sing. Good news for people everywhere. Good news of joy for all to share. Good news for God has kept his word and sent his Saviour Christ the Lord. The one he promised he would send is born this day in Bethlehem. And this will be a sign for you. This is how you'll know it's true. You'll find a baby wrapped in cloth, sleeping in a cattle trough.
The angels then was joined by more, 6 and 12 and 24, and then too many more to number. A heaven choir loudest thunder. And so the angels left that place, just like they'd come, without a trace, except for all they sang and said, which echoed in the shepherds' heads. Let's go to Bethlehem and see, the shepherds all as one agreed. They found the baby where he lay, asleep upon a bed of hay.
They told them what the angels said. Then Mary smiled and raised her head, a secret hid there in her eyes, for she was not one bit surprised. So back they went to sheep and hill, no longer silent, hardly still, but singing loud like angels bright of all that they had seen that night.
Sing praise to God and give him glory. Celebrate his wondrous story of love and joy and peace to men, for it begins in Bethlehem.
Thank you, Lord, for angel songs that shout aloud the Saviour's birth. Show us how to live in ways that sing again of peace on earth.
Now it's time for time to pass. The star watchers are following their star, but it takes them time to get to Bethlehem. So they don't arrive the night the shepherds do. No, it's probably something like a year or more later when they knock on King Herod's door.
Can you join in with the chorus? These are the actions. One hump, two hump, lumpety lump. The star watchers wept with a thump and a bump. One hump, two hump, lumpety lump. The star watchers followed the star. One hump, two hump, lumpety lump. The star watchers wept with a thump and a bump. One hump, two hump, lumpety lump. The star watchers followed the star.
The star watchers watched the stars go by, looking for secrets in the sky. And then they saw a special star away in the west, away off far. A king's being born, that's what it means. Judea way or so it seems. They climbed aboard their camely beasts and set off west from their homes back east.
One hump, two hump, lumpety lump, the star watchers wept with a thump and a bump. One hump, two hump, lumpety lump, the star watchers followed the star.
At last their journey came to an end. They parked their camels in Jerusalem. Then they went to Herod, king of the nation, to ask him for some information. O king, they asked, they were quite polite, somewhere around here on this starry night, a brand new baby king abides. Can you tell us where this child resides?
A worried look crossed Herod's face. He had no plans of being replaced. So he asked his priests if they could tell where this brand new baby king might dwell. The priests all answered straight away, Bethlehem is what the prophet says. Then Herod thought an evil thing. I think I need to meet this king. Star watchers, friends, King Herod smiled. In Bethlehem, you'll find the child. Would you tell me where you'll find him, please? The exact address would put my mind at ease. King Herod, of course, told them a lie. He had already planned for the child to die. When he found the boy, that's what he'd do. So the star watchers left without a clue.
Hello, everybody. I was told to give a reading for this other king, so I'll do just that. The shining star led them to the place. A simple house, not some fancy space. And when they saw the little boy, they gave him a pile of special toys. Presents rather fit for a king. A bunch of shiny golden things. A spice called myrrh, the sort of perfume, while smelly frankincense filled the room. Then in the night, they had a dream that showed them Herod's evil scheme. So they never said where the boy's house lay, but went straight home by another way.
One hump, two hump, lumpety lump, the star watchers wept with a thump and a bump. One hump, two hump, lumpety lump, the star watchers followed the star.
Lord, help us be like star watchers, following your lead, looking for your guidance in every word and deed.
We've had a lovely time celebrating the Christmas story. We do it every year. We do it for a reason, and that's why there is one last poem. So what is the point of angels and shepherds and camels and stars, you say? It is a nice story to tell to the children to celebrate Christmas Day. It's not just a story, it's not just for kids. It's the hinge on which history swings. That Bethlehem baby grew into a man, who challenged all powers and kings. He taught us that love is better than hate, that serving beats being in charge. He showed us the value of each human life, the little as well as the large. And then on a cross, he died for us, died to take all our wrongs away, and walked 3 days later, right out of his tomb, to turn death's dark night to day. And that is the good news that angels proclaimed, the heart of all Jesus would do. A new life for now, a new life forever, that is his Christmas present to you.